The second aspect of our morning teaching is the family life. And our topic this morning is sexual abstinence. Sexual what?
Abstinence.
We started this service last Sunday, and we said that sexual abstinence is the period you want to stop, you want to restrain yourself, the time you don't want to have sex. And I say that it has to do with married people, probably the time they want to pray. They say we want to fast and we don't want to have sex so that we focus on our spiritual life. Then I also said that last Sunday that sexual abstinence mostly is very important, especially for the singles. Singles in the sense that one of the importance of the sexual abstinence for the singles is that it helps them to concentrate on their careers. I talked also about those who are in their academics. It helps them to face their studies squarely. I told them that if you add sex to your academic pursuit, you may end up winning one and losing the other. Some students, mostly the females, got pregnant in the line of their academics and they were withdrawn. The school say, go home and continue your family wahala. We can't keep pregnant woman here who has no husband. Because when you were admitted, you did not tell us that you are married. We checked your marital status then, you wrote single. Now you are pregnant. Is it the teacher that will not take over the brain? In fact, go home. And the child, the students packed and left the school, probably secretly in the night. But the boy that got this girl pregnant, nobody talks to him. He's continuing his lectures. He comes to school. He do everything that everybody is doing. And he will graduate successful from that same school while this girl will be at home looking for how to fry akara, looking for who will give her money to start selling fried, roasted corn. Sometimes carrying pure down the head with a baby being backed. You know, they are almost everywhere, looking for who will employ them. They say, with your picking, we can't employ your mother. So these are some of the things that singles are supposed to look at, because the boy that tells you today that I love you so much, if pregnancy comes in, this boy will run away. What you're supposed to be pursuing now, supposed to be your school. How to get better grades, good grades, and graduate well. Your career, if you have finished your school, which is the reason why we are talking about the will of God in our first teaching. If you know the will of God for your life, why not pursue it? Because the will of God for a single now is not to get pregnant. Are we understanding how this thing relates? The will of God for a single who has not married is not to be pregnant. So this one will remove anybody that is coming for the will of God for you to get pregnant. Yes. This one is not my one. This one will not enter. And if you continue pursuing it, it will become the permissive will of God. And you go get the pregnancy now. And you go carry out. Then, and you give birth to the baby. They will still come to bless the baby and call the baby blessing. But this is another added load. This blessing is not going to be blessing indeed. So we need to understand this. It's the will of God for me to befriend this boy or this girl. But along the line, at your present status now, being a single, it's not the will of God for you to be in relationship. What you're supposed to relate more is your school, your career, your academies, your books. These are the core friendship that you're supposed to make. All right? So I made us understand. Why am I taking this thing back is that most of us were not here last Sunday. Not only that, there is something that comes with revision. And when you revise, some of us did not read the notes like you read your own, but some because of chance. But when we are revising, like even me that is talking, some other ideas are coming. So you now see, you are now sitting in two different classes, last Sunday class and today's class. So if you get pregnant along the line of your being a student, even if the school allow you to continue, it will be stressful on you. Because a pregnant woman is supposed to have rest. But to see the stress with school, from lecture, this department to another department, you must go there. Sometimes we that will pass through the courses that we see plenty today, you will be struggling to enter with your pregnancy. You won't go again after you go home today. So these are the things you're supposed to look at. Even when I was in school, we had two students that got pregnant and they did not complete with us. You know, that intelligent, it happens mostly to intelligent students, you know. Now, we are going to look at the dangers associated with, because I just mentioned that of pregnancy and the withdrawal. As a public health instructor, we look at more of things that happen to our health. Because when we look at things happening in the spiritual realm, most of them will be saying every time you're quoting the Bible. And even those people, where they quote, then they do. There are ways when, I think one of our sisters, he said something the other day, he mentioned, say, poor good girl, help. You see the language now. If you have to be a good girl, he's teaching her to be a good, who did this good girl ever help? That is, if you have to keep your virginity, waiting the virginity don't do for person. But the health aspect of it will be very important to you.
Yes,
because this time we're not talking about going to heaven with virginity. We're not even talking about keeping the virginity for your husband, who you never know. Because some people will come and teach it in a different way, that you are keeping the virginity as a gift for the husband that is somewhere giving some people pregnant. That is the one you are keeping your virginity for. It looks like the girl is being cheated. He's keeping virginity for one promiscuous boy that is everywhere looking for this one. He's a virgin. Let me go and pregnant him. So you two, you are just like this. I'm waiting for my husband, my gift of virginity. It doesn't really make sense. But at least your health here, it makes sense, because if you admit it, even if you are no longer a student, and they say what landed you in the hospital is because of sexual transmitted diseases, at least your body go weak. Because these are preventable diseases that you wouldn't have landed yourself if you didn't commit this sexual intercourse with the person. So we're going to look at dangers associated with it from the health angle. I remember last Sunday when I was talking, I said that the spiritual side of it is that it makes you to have a free mind to approach God. That, God, I am not committing this fornication that you don't want. And it makes you to feel free that when you're talking to God, you are talking from the mind of somebody who is perfect. And today we're looking at the health aspect, and we are hammering on the sexual transmitted diseases that is associated with committing sexual intercourse. One of them is the one they call syphilis. Is the spelling. Now, syphilis, as we said, has to come with the poor, or it comes with, let me use the word that we are used to, it comes with something like pimple, but they call it chancre. The spelling is like this. Now, it doesn't really pain, but the problem with syphilis is that the symptom that it gives to you varies with the symptom that it will give to me, based on our different biological makeup. Mm. Some people got infected by syphilis and it affected their brain. While the one that gave the syphilis to that person, it was still there, nobody really noticed it. Some people, it affected their eyes and they became blind person. Some, it didn't affect the woman, but it affected the child that the woman gave birth to. So that's why we have to be careful with sexual transmitted disease. I know somebody's mind is telling him or her that after all, I'm going to use condom. How can it penetrate through condom? We are coming to that. All right, the next one here is the trichomoniasis. Do we really need to write this big biological?
Dangerous names.
Niasis. You are close, you see my write-up, because the video or the write-up is already fading. Now, this one comes with a discharge. Vaginal discharge that smells like fish. You pass, people will be like, oh, you carry crayfish passing. The person is infected by trichomoniasis. So, another one is the one called chlamydia.
It's looking like this.
This is the spelling of chlamydia. This one, when it catches the woman, it affects the urinary tract. A little thing, she is feeling urgency to go and urinate. That urgency to go and urinate, she will not urinate enough. And she don't come back. You want to see the spelling? All right. So that also distracts you, makes you not to be comfortable. And they may behave as if they have gone, but sometimes they will come back. And you continue to be on drugs. And you know, most of the drugs for all these things are hard drugs. The one they call antibiotics. All the antibiotics that are to be used for these things has a way of affecting our beta body parts.
Yes.
Because they are poisons on their own, being sent on a message to go and poison that thing that is worrying you. So sometimes they affect our healthy cells. You went to urinate, you are perceiving the odor of that thing you took. Most of us can testify to when you urinate, you begin to perceive odor of amphicloss, the one we are so much used to. So most of the times you urinate, you see color changes. You think all is well. But most of the times things are not well. Your healthy body parts are being reduced by this chemical you are taking. And at times you cannot take in them, but you still not be healed. So the best way to do them is to avoid anything that will bring you close to someone in the name of sex. Because most of the problem those who got married and began to pray for a child is from what they passed through when they were single. Most of them, nobody came this world, God created not to give birth. It's when you have any of these mistakes along the line of your good, then you jam them. Then another one we need to look at here is the gonorrhea, the almighty gonorrhea. Gonorrhea, as I explained to you the other day, comes with a pus along the line of where they call the urethra. Do I need to write the spelling of gonorrhea for you? This is it. This is G-O-N-O-R-R-H-E-A. So it makes the person that when you want to urinate you will be suffering because the urine comes with salt, uric acid, and other substances that when they touch that pus, that wound inside the line of the urethra, you feel pain, feel pepper. So for you not to feel any of this pain, run away from sex while you are not married. It will save you from any of these things. Then, for those of us that say condom is there, you just use condom and you'll be free from sickness. I told us about the one called simplex. Rule. This thing is going to be more writing. I know you've written it last Sunday. So this one, which is called HSV, we have the type 1 and type 2. It happens to the men at the part called the penile shaft and the base, whereby even if you put the condom, it will not still reach or cover it very well. So when your body is contacting with the body of your girlfriend, you end up contacting her with HIPS, simplex, virus. So these are the things we need to be careful, because none of us say before me and you will have sex, we have to go and begin to do medical checkup. Even when you do medical checkup, some of them will not show until you do the type of medical checkup called VDRL. This medical test called Venereal Disease Research Laboratory. So when you do that, it will help to show all the venereal diseases. Then when they say venereal, all the sexual transmitted diseases. Still, sometimes it doesn't really show well if the person's own has not come up very well. So that's why The best is to practice sexual abstinence. All right? We have the one called oral herpes. If I'm here to show you the pictures of those who contacted herpes through kissing. We did not have sex, but we only kissed. Unknown to you that the person has it in his or her mouth. And if he comes, I told her that when I was in the pharmacy industry in 2003, we sold herpes simplest virus drug, the one they call Aciclovir, 3,000 naira, 2003, man. 2003 now supposed to be 20. Many years. As at that time. And you have to take that for just 5 days. And you are going to buy that one. The rashes will see the drug and do, may we keep quiet. He will, this one will finish. He will go and buy. If he didn't buy that one, will come up. So it will cross over. So these are the things we need to be very careful. What of the one called the lymphogranuloma? I'm not going to write this one because it's long and I don't want to disturb you people. They call it lymphogranuloma venereum. Whereby if it enters your body, sometimes you see something will begin to pain you here. In Hausa, they call it maru. You begin to feel pain here that you won't bring your hand down. Sometimes it happens at the groin region. All these things, they call them the sympathy organs. These sympathy organs are angry for what that is happening inside your body. They are symptoms of what is happening inside. These pains you are feeling here are not your big problem. Your major problem is what brought the pains. What brought this thing that makes your hand, you can't bring it down. So these are the ones they call the lymphogranuloma venereum. So we need to also be careful. So the swelling of the lymph nodes. Then we are going to conclude here on the HIV, the one that if they talk about sexual transmitted disease, your mind will just go straight to HIV. And that is the one most of us do test for. You say, have you checked your HIV? Most of us don't ask for these ones that I mentioned. Well, what am I going to talk much about on HIV that all of us doesn't know? HIV has become an everyday grammar that all of us know. So I will just talk to you on that and go straight to, because of the time now, when you did not contact any of these things, and God help you, give you what you're looking for, which is pregnancy. Because when you are going for sex, definitely you are looking for how to get a child. Some now would now like to do abortion. Now, in the line of abortion, so many of our sisters lost their lives based on the person who did the abortion for them. Some did not die, but the abortion did not go well as it's supposed to be. So the incomplete abortion now ended up rupturing some parts of the womb that's supposed to be okay, then it becomes not okay. So when this woman now grew up, get married, want to give birth, there will be problem at the place where this baby will be. So you begin to hear something like miscarriage. So it's something that we need to be careful, because I know at the age you are, the age called the teenage, from your 10 to 18 to 20 is where these things happen, where the hormones in you are vibrant, looking for, you know, is the one that if you, you don't allow it to direct you, it will just mislead you. So it's good for us to get these things in our mind, because most of our parents doesn't really take us into this. They only tell us to be virgin because we are going to, is what a gift we are going to give our husband the day of wedding. And what of the day after? So I don't want to take much of our time. We have taken this course last Sunday, and I know today, even if you have a question, I gave you books. Help me write it down. We will continue from where we stopped. And I will put our heads together for Jesus.
Clap, clap, our teacher. Wonderful.